I'm originally from Wilmington, North Carolina, and I did my undergrad at North Carolina State University. When I applied to grad schools, I visited four different programs. In the area of research I do, which is modeling healthcare policy, there's a lot of great opportunities here at Stanford and here at MS&E. My advisor, Margaret Brandeau, has a lot of connections with the School of Medicine, and also our department has a lot of connections with the hospital system here at Stanford. There's a lot of opportunities for students to do projects there. Before going to grad school, I was working with hospitals as a cost management consultant. I began to wonder whether the quantitative tools I was using to improve operations in hospitals could be applied to broader questions of healthcare policy and clinical guidelines. So I just Googled operations research and healthcare policy, and one of the first things that came up was a book chapter by Margaret Brandeau, who's a professor here at MS&E. Reading that chapter is what made me decide, like, I want to do work like this, and I decided I wanted to pursue a PhD, and I was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to come to Stanford and work with Margaret. More specifically, within the area of modeling healthcare decisions and healthcare policy, my research focuses on safety in the blood supply and keeping blood donors and transfusion recipients safe. I became interested in that topic when I just saw a mobile blood drive happening on campus and began to wonder about the questions of who's allowed to donate and how those decisions are made. And as I researched that topic, I learned that there's an organization in San Francisco called Vitalant Research Institute who has a lot of expertise in this area. And I've collaborated with people up there, such as Brian Custer, and they've been really involved in my dissertation ever since. In my first year in the department, first and second year, I became involved with the social committee for MS&E, and I was also asked this year to become a mentor for the Enhancing Diversity in Graduate Education program, or the EDGE fellowship program. So I mentor some students through that. And I also really enjoy hiking during the weekends and skiing during the winter. Students in my research area, a lot of them go into academia and other ones will go into industry. But within academia, some students end up in an engineering department. Some students end up being a professor of public health, of health services research, or in a business school. Personally, I really like doing work that's really applied to healthcare problems rather than more theoretical work. So I think I'm most likely to end up as a professor, hopefully, in a school of public health or in a faculty of medicine. So for advice for an incoming student, I think there's two main pieces. One is to not be intimidated. When I first was visiting as a prospective student, I felt like I was one of the only people from a state school and everyone else needed to know what they were doing. And then again, when it came time to start doing research, I didn't know where to start. But what I learned really was with research, the only way to learn how to do research is just to start practicing and start doing it. I also learned that it's really valuable when you're working on something to get your idea in front of someone else who can give you feedback very early on. I think a lot of students don't want to put preliminary or half-baked ideas in front of their advisor because they don't want to be judged. But being wrong is part of the research process, and it's okay to put your ideas out there, and it's actually essential to get feedback for you to help developing them. My other main piece of advice would be to speak with other students in the department, particularly students who are 1, 2, or 3 years ahead of you. Because for me, talking to the other students in my research area as well as other research areas has been super helpful as I navigate PhD life.